Hello, my dear ones. How are you? Did you read the lesson? Very interesting lesson, isn't it? About the magic porridge pot. Did you read that? How do you spell magic? M-A-G-I-C, magic. How do you spell magic? M-A-G-I-C, magic. M-A-G-I-C, magic. How do you spell porridge? P-O-R-R-I-D-G-E. P-O-R-R-I-D-G-E, porridge. When you write the letters, one letter should not touch the other letter. See, there should be little gap. Only then you will be able to know the letter difference and the formation should be correct. Okay, the formation of the letter also should be proper. P-O-R-R-R. Don't have to say R-R, you say R-R means double means two. P-O-R-R-I-D-G-E, porridge. What's the spelling of town? T-O-W-N, town. T-O-W-N, town. T-O-W-N, town. Cooking. C-O-O-K-I-N-G, cooking. C-O-O-K-I-N-G is cooking. Did you learn all the spellings? You have to read the lesson. How many times you can, you should read the lesson, okay? Then, who did she meet? She met an old woman. Who did she meet? She met an old woman. How do you spell woman?
W-O-M-A-N,
woman. We have already learned this, but we are just revising once more to make the spellings thorough. Thorough means to make it know better. Okay. Now, spell the word mother. M-O-T-H-E-R, mother. All the other words which is there is all we know, and there is no tough words in it. And little, L-I-T-T-L-E, little. Little opposite is lot. So all of you keep your book ready. Take page number 8. Take page number 8. Take B. Tick correct options. Whom does the little girl meet? Keep your book ready. It's given there. An old woman, an old man. Whom did she meet? She met an old woman. So tick the first column. Put a tick mark on the first column. What does the magic pot cook? Rice, porridge. What did it cook? Yes, it cooked porridge. The second column. Tick the second column. Tick means this is a tick mark. Put a tick mark like this. Okay? In the book. Did you do it? Yes. Okay, now next one is fill in the blanks. Dash, little pot, dash. What did they say? Yes, they said, cook, little pot, cook. Use capital C. Cook, little pot. Then what did again they say? Cook. So, repeat the same word in the dash. Cook, little pot, cook. Soon the kitchen is full of, what was there? Full of porridge. P-O, now it's already there, P-O-R-R-I-D-G-E, porridge. In the blank here, in this blank, we got to write porridge. Cook, little pot, cook first one. Second one is, the town was full of porridge. Soon the kitchen, not town, the soon the kitchen was full of porridge. Third one, soon the dash is full of dash. After the kitchen, what happened? Yes, the full house. How do you spell house? H-O-U-S-E, house. House was full of? Full of what? House was full of porridge. Fourth one. Soon the whole what? Town. T-O-W-N. Town. Now there is a town here. The town was full of porridge. Soon the town was full of porridge. First, where was porridge spread all over? Yes, first the kitchen, then the house, then the full town was full of porridge. And now come to page number 10. See, in, on, under, near, over, behind. These are known as prepositions. What are these? Prepositions. To show the position of a thing. That is called preposition. Now I am going to write here. The book is dash the
table. The book is dash the table. Now the book, we have already said about the book, but where the book is, where the place it is kept, where the book is kept. Table is given there, but where it is kept we do not know. So we have to write here the preposition, the position where the book is. That's called the preposition. What is it? Preposition. The book is, now we can write here on. So the position of the book, where it is, it's on the table. Now the fish is dash the water. Fish is dash the water. Now the fish, we know the fish is there, the water is there, but we do not know where it is, isn't it? So we are going to write here which position the fish is in. The fish is in the water. The fish is in the water. Now the cat jumped dash the wall. Now what preposition you can use here? The cat jumped over the wall. The cat jumped over the wall. That means it is, yes, over the wall. It jumped over the wall. So you take that picture. There is a picture given there, and you can see duck in it, a boy there, a girl, and a monkey. And now look at that. Now read these sentences so you will know where the prepositions it is used and where each thing is and what the, where the girl is, where the monkey is. The ducks are in the pond. You can see two ducks. They are in the pond. The monkey is on the tree. The girl is sitting under. So on, in, under, behind, all these are prepositions. It's to show the position of a thing or a person is. The girl is sitting under the tree. The boy is standing behind the fence. So that's a fence. The word in, on, under, and behind tell where the things and persons are. Those words are called prepositions to show the position of a thing, where it is, a thing or a person or whatever it is given here, to show where it is, to show the thing where it is, that is called the preposition. What is it? Preposition. Now look at the pictures and circle the correct prepositions. There are three prepositions given there. Now you see the porridge is dash the pot. The porridge is, where the porridge is? The porridge is in the pot. The porridge is in the pot. It is inside the pot. So you only circle that. There are three options given there. Yep. On, in, and near. It's given there. On, in, near. So you got to circle in. Okay? Circle in. Preposition in. Second one. That is page number 11. Take page number 11. The little boy is dash the umbrella. Now where the little boy is, you can see that picture there. My book is in a bad position, so I cannot bring it to the, because it's all falling out. That's why I'm not able to. Anyway, I'll try. See where the boy is. Can you see? Yes, the boy is under the umbrella. He's holding the umbrella and is under the umbrella. So circle under, U-N-D-E-R. Next one, third picture. The man is dash the horse. Where is the man? Yes, is on the horse. So circle O-N on. Fourth one, the child is dash the curtain. It's given there on, in, behind. Where is the child? Yes, the child is behind. B-E-H-I-N-D. Circle behind. The ball is, look at the ball, where it is. The ball is dash the grass, on the grass, under the grass, near the grass. Where is it? It is on the grass, O-N, on. The dog jumps dash the fence. How is he jumping? Is it on or in? No, over. The dog jumps over the fence. The dog jumps over the fence. I shall come back.